Welcome or welcome back with my friend
Sandro.
Today I actually found something interesting. It was on some recommendations as well. It was how 1,000 Filipino soldiers or troops fought alongside allied forces versus 40,000 Chinese troops. That was a really interesting title, kind of clickbaity, so they got me. So I really want to see it, so let's go.
Let's go!
Let's go. Really interesting.
In honor of those
know.
Who sacrificed their lives for freedom, Masid proudly presents the Battle of Yultong, a story of how Filipino troops braved a sea of Chinese soldiers during the Korean War. The Korean War began
this.
On June 25, 1950, when North Korea, backed by China and the Soviet Union, crossed the border into South Korea in an attempt to capture its capital, Seoul. In response, the United Nations Security Council, through the formation of the United Nations Command, ordered the deployment of military forces to stop the invasion.
Interesting style.
On August 7, 1950, President Elpidio Quirino, with approval from Congress, sent 7,420 Filipino combat troops to fight in South Korea. President Quirino saw this as a commitment to help a friend and as part of a larger battle to save the world from communism. The 10th Battalion Combat Team, the Philippine Expeditionary Forces to Korea, was the first battalion to arrive on Busan shores on September 19, 1950. The 10th Battalion, made up of 1,303 enlisted men and 64 officers, was originally a motorized battalion sent to operate tanks from the US. But when none arrived, was turned into a heavy weaponry unit instead. On the night of April 22, the 10th Battalion, as part of the U.S. 65th Infantry Regiment of the U.S. 3rd Infantry Division, was attacked north of Yeoncheon by a large force of Chinese and North Korean soldiers. This would be known in history as the Great Spring Offensive, one of the largest offensives by the 44th Division of the Chinese People's Volunteer Army and the Communist North Korean Army during the Korean War. In front of the Filipinos were four Chinese divisions, numbering about 40,000 men. Just after midnight, the Chinese began their attack
with
a heavy artillery barrage.
To defend.
Soon after, the Chinese forces advanced, but had difficulty as the 10th Battalion successfully defended their positions with mortar and artillery. However, a massive Chinese assault pushed the Turkish brigade from their position, allowing the Chinese to surround the Filipinos' eastern side. Seeing the incoming danger, Lieutenant Colonel Junicio Ojeda immediately organized a unit of battalion cooks and clerks to fortify and defend the east flank. With the help of M24 light tanks and artillery support, Lieutenant Colonel Ojeda's makeshift unit was able to hold off the advancing Chinese forces. The situation only got worse when the Puerto Rican 65th Infantry Regiment, situated on the west flank, began to fall back from Chinese attack. With the west flank now exposed, the Chinese began advancing but were blocked by a platoon of Filipino soldiers situated on a hill overlooking Yultong. Commanded by Lieutenant Jose Arciaga, this platoon refused to yield and held their ground. This gave Lieutenant Arciaga's company commander, Captain Conrado Yap, enough time to mount a counterattack. The counterattack successfully extracted the trapped platoon from the hill and also stopped the Chinese from further advancing. But sadly, Lieutenant Arciaga and Captain Yap were killed during the fight. In the early morning of April 23, Lieutenant Colonel Ojeda led the second counterattack using M24 tanks. This caught the Chinese off guard and pushed them away from the hill they were trying to seize. The Filipinos fought until midday before it was ordered to withdraw and link up with the rest of the division in the south. 15 Filipino soldiers died, 26 were wounded, and 14 were missing in action, while the Chinese and North Koreans lost around 500 soldiers. The 10th Battalion's effort at Yultong allowed the U.S. 3rd Infantry Division to successfully withdraw from the battlefield, which would later on prove to turn the war in favor of the Allies. 2 weeks later, the Communists began ceasefire negotiations after suffering more heavy losses. For the next 2 years, the Korean War was mostly battled from hilltops, until a ceasefire was finally declared. Out of the 7,420 Filipino soldiers sent, 113 were killed, 313 wounded, 15 missing, and 41 held as prisoners of war. Today, a monument stands inside the War Memorial of Korea, in honor of the many Filipino soldiers who fought for the liberation of Korea. Recently, During the 69th anniversary of the Korean War, the late Captain Conrado Yap was awarded the Taiguk Medal, the highest military decoration given to a soldier for bravery in combat. Also awarded the Taiguk Medal was fellow 10th Battalion team member Major Maximo Young for his heroism at the Battle of Myeongdong. The efforts of the 10th Battalion in the Battle of Yultong was instrumental in turning the tide of the war in favor of the Allied forces. South Korea remains a free democracy, thanks to the contribution of soldiers like the Fighting Filipinos, a name given by the U.S. command to the brave men of the 10th Battalion combat team. Did you like our story? Are there other heroic adventures of Filipinos you want us to feature?
Let us know
in the comment box. Don't forget to like this video. Also, subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Thanks for watching.
Interesting way to tell it, but it's actually kind of clear how he did it.
Yeah, I don't like the cartoony style though.
No, not true. True, but I like the information that was told, yeah. And then of course some showing. Otherwise, it's just him.
Just telling a story. Yeah.
Maybe with some black and white pictures that kind of can be as well. Okay, but one of the things that I found interesting was the. He said then he found a couple of cooks and other people and to surround it. In the Netherlands, we always have your soldier first before your specialization. So everybody is trained as the normal soldier before you get your specialization in whatever it is, in engineer or cook or...
Everybody knows the basics.
Basics, yeah. So I think this was as well. You can just say it's cooks like out of a civilian. So I think he just got... a squad of them, but they are not trained to fight on a higher level way. So it's like basic. So that's really brave of him to do, and then it succeeded as well. It's really a nice tale that he portrayed about
having
high crime. True. And you can really see that the officers that did come, they have a real good plan to have this kind of defense. And I think whenever you have high ground, of course, that helps a lot. Like, yeah, like that makes makes a lot. What did you
say?
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah, short and sweet, I guess. I think we'll find these kinds of stories more. I really like these. It portrays a heroic story of the Filipinos. We have those as well from the Netherlands. I don't think it's portrayed this way. So I really like how he did it. I'm not too fond of the cartoony as well, but it did show the story in a great way.
Good story.
That's it. If you have any other recommendations, leave it. If you have these kind of stories, let us know as well, because I really do enjoy it, the way he told it. I'll leave the link in the description below so you can check it out for yourself, the channel. And thank you all for watching. Until the next time. Deuces.
Bye.